much is this one?
95, madam. That's a genuine amethyst.
No, too much. Haven't you something cheaper, but looks more expensive?
I've shown you our entire stock, madam.
Well, I don't think I want a new clip anyway. Thanks just the same.
Not at all, madam. Glad to serve you. Good day, madam.
Good day.
Yes, madam. You're a fat old fool, madam. I hope you choke, madam. Mamie, keep an eye on the stand for me, will you? I'll be back in a minute.
Okay, Betty, go ahead.
Why do we have to search the place again? We went through it twice yesterday. I've been seeing lace pants in my sleep.
Ah, these stealing epidemics come and go. As soon as we make a pinch, they'll let up.
Hey,
McGuire says if we don't find nothing in these lockers, we gotta search the girls.
Well, that'll be an improvement.
You start over there.
Well, what do you know about...
Well, how do you like that? Big as life.
I had a hunch the crook was going to get careless.
Gee, now I don't get a chance to search Miss Rickenstall.
Listen, lovebug, forget Miss Rickenstall. We got to report the dame that belongs to this locker. Mary Turner.
Mr. Gilder?
Yes?
McGuire speaking. We've got her.
Bring her up. I'll deal with this one myself. Have Mr. Demarest here when McGuire arrives.
Yes, sir.
And, what time did they call from the airport?
Over half an hour ago. He ought to be here any minute.
Mm. What a boy, Sarah. Left Los Angeles at 3 o'clock this morning, and he'll be in the store for lunch. That's a record, Sarah. 330 miles an hour, continuous flight. Down once. That's going places. I don't know where he gets it.
Maybe his father had something to do with it.
No, no. He's more of a well-beater than I ever was.
Hello, Joe.
Hello, Mr. Gilder.
Hello, Dad.
Well, Slowpoke, what delayed you?
I got a little bit lost, Dad.
Well, I suppose if that hadn't happened, you'd have been here for breakfast.
Yeah, I suppose I would. Hey, that's my tie.
Well, you can get another one.
How are you, sir?
Sit down, Mr. Gilder. You must be awfully tired.
Well, I am a little.
I'll send Mr. Demarest right in, Mr. Gilder.
Well, son, you did a good job.
Everything broke good for me. Weather, wind, and nothing fell off the engine.
Dick, I got a little surprise for you. I'm opening up an airplane department.
Dad, that's swell.
The only department store in the country carrying a line of airplanes. And you're in charge. Now let's see if you can break any records as a salesman.
Well, that's marvelous, Dad. We'll clean up.
Well, I don't know about cleaning up, but we'll attract a little attention and we may sell an extra pair of gloves.
I'll have all your customers doing tailspins within a week. Well, I've got to get bathed and changed. I'll see you at lunch.
All right.
Hello, Dick. Congratulations.
Thanks, Mr. Demarest. How's the attorney business? Still squaring traffic tags?
Not since you've been away.
Ouch. That'll teach me a point. See you later.
So long, Dick. You want to see me, Mr. Gilder?
Yes, George. McGuire's got the thief.
Good. Mr. Gilder, I hope you won't weaken and let this one go the way you did the last one.
Not if I've got a case. I've had my lesson.
You've been much too lenient. You have to make an example of these people.
Is McGuire there?
Yes, Mr. Gilder.
Send him in.
Hello, Sarah. Mr. Gilder, Mac's making a terrible mistake.
They caught her red-handed, Mr. Gilder. This stuff was right in her locker.
You must have gotten into the wrong locker. It couldn't have been mine.
There's no mistake, Mr. Gilder. Not possibly. Topaz clip, $175. Gold earrings, $80. Gold and platinum money clip, $95. A cigarette case, $65 in her coat pocket.
Well, how'd they get there?
That's what we're asking you.
Well, you don't... You can't think I stole them.
You didn't buy them, did you?
Don't look at me like that. I didn't... I'm not a thief. I never stole anything in my life. Well, can't you see I'm telling the truth? Please, please, believe me.
But the jewelry is found in your possession.
No, in my locker. But I didn't put it there.
I suppose somebody else stole them and put them in your locker.
Well, yes, yes, they must have.
How could anyone else get in your locker?
I don't know. I must have left it unlocked.
Look, Mr. Gilder, I found these in her purse.
Pawn tickets. Perhaps you can explain that, miss.
Yes, they're for my watch and dressing case. I had to have some money. I'm studying at night school. Designing. I want to be a buyer.
Then you do admit that you needed money?
No. Well, yes, just a little. Oh, I see. Mr. Gilder, don't listen to them. Don't you see that I'm not lying? Do you think I could look at you like this if I'd ever stolen anything from you?
It's no use, Miss Turner. You can't act your way out of this. We're only wasting time.
Come along, Miss Turner.
Mr. Gilder, aren't you going to give me a chance to prove I'm innocent?
You'll get your chance in court.
In court? In court?
Mary Turner, you've been found guilty of grand larceny in the second degree. Have you anything to say before sentence is pronounced?
Yes, Your Honor. Mr. Gilder, once more I swear to you before God I'm not a thief. You're punishing an innocent person.
If you would re-employ this girl, I could give her probation.
No, Your Honor, I'm sorry, but I feel that I must let the law take its course.
Then it becomes my duty, Miss Turner, to sentence you to 3 years in the state prison. The sentence may seem severe, but the law is explicit. Without recommendation from the complainant, I have no other course.
Without recommendation. One word from you and this wouldn't happen to me. But you won't say it. Oh, how dare you not say it? How dare you take 3 years of my life and ruin the rest of it just to save a few of your rotten dollars?
Take her away.
3 years isn't forever, Mr. Gilder. When I come out, you're going to pay me for every minute of it. There won't be a day or an hour when I won't remember what you've done to me, and you're going to pay me for it. You took away every chance I had to be happy, and that's a lot to pay for. But you're going to do it, do you hear me? You're going to pay me and pay me in full!
Well, well. Hasn't changed a bit. I was sort of hoping they'd put in a penthouse.
Come on, Mary.
You know, it really isn't so bad. It's a great place to climb on the wagon and get a good rest.
Is it?
Yeah, and besides, nobody can get you on the telephone. You don't have to worry about what you're going to wear, money, or getting your hair fixed.
I guess that's right.
Come on, you can do 3 years standing on your head. Cheer up.
Thanks, I'll try.
Come on, girls.
Miss Barton.
What are you looking at?
Just my luck. The last man I'm going to see in 2 years, and he's got to look like you.
What was the charge?
Well, I had some letters an old chinchucker wrote me.
Blackmail. Next. Name?
Mary Turner.
Alias?
Just Mary Turner.
Birthplace?
Lower Massachusetts.
Age?
22.
Parents?
Not living.
Who brought you up?
St. Martha's Orphanage.
Charge?
Grand larceny.
Next.
You might as well throw the jewelry away. By the time I get out, it'll be out of date.
So will you.
Oh, no. Real beauty never goes out of style.
Hey, you. Come back here, you real beauty, and hand it over.
Oh, come on. Be a sport.
It helps like anything to have one.
You heard me. Hand it over. They're against the rule, and you know it.
Take a good look at yourself. Don't worry, Mary. The way these pictures look, your own mother wouldn't recognize you.
That'll be enough of that.
Hold it.
In the old days, we used to exchange photos with the boys from Sing Sing.